Beautiful Capricorns, hello, hello. This is your bonus reading. Let's get straight to your messages. Thank you for joining me here, Capricorn. I hope each and every one of you are doing amazing. Thank you so much for all of your contributions, your generosity by commenting. You guys, thank you so much for all you do. Let's go, Capricorn, please. Whoa, somebody, what the hell is going on here? Somebody is regretting not trusting you, or is regretting not trusting you. They could have been blaming you. They could have been punishing you. They could have been judging you. Maybe somebody is learning some kind of lesson here. I don't know. There is some kind of plan here. Plotting and planning here. Based on someone's insecurity. Somebody may have tried to control you. This could be a family situation or family. Or the fact that you've taken your power back and you're happy. It's almost like someone regrets blocking this relationship. Could be a King of Wands. Being selfish here and regretting it. What's going on here? So they're jealous. They could be jealous that you've moved on. Somebody is jealous that you've moved on. And I think they look at you with regret. I think that they look at you as if you were their Ten of Cups. And I think they are embarrassed. And I think they're feeling guilty. And I think they're feeling ashamed. Well, they're feeling overwhelmed right now. Somebody is feeling overwhelmed with whatever decision or choice is here. Because it's almost like you've stood your ground to this person. You're moving on. You took your power back and you did the respectful thing. You stood your ground to this person and they don't like it. I think they're jealous of anyone that respects you. I think that they're jealous of anyone who it's like you're happy here. Okay? And they don't like you standing up to them. They don't. They don't. I'm almost getting feeling the energy of the audacity of you to stand up for yourself, or the audacity of you to take your power back, the audacity of you to be happy. Or is it because they got caught? Yeah, you may have caught them. And they could have been. They're spying on you. Trying to dig up facts and information on you. From a distance. It's because you're ignoring them. Someone who you've rejected or you're no longer interested in is spying on you. Could be online. You're not interested. Okay. You've changed. You're not interested. So they're jealous. Like you're healing here. And they ain't liking it. At all this pain and hurt. So they put you through too much, like they did too much. And now they're sitting there feeling like they're the ones that got betrayed, feeling like they're the ones who have been wounded and hurt. Oh, yeah, they're mad. Look, I cannot make it up. Look. This emperor's pissed at the empress. Why? Because you healed. Because you're happy. Because you've made the changes and you've got the Wheel of Fortune and you've taken your power back. And they're pissed off. This emperor is mad at this empress. Look, I don't know if they're mad at themselves. I don't know if they are hearing gossip and thinking you betrayed them or something, but you didn't. They're mad at you. They're holding a grudge now. It's because you're not interested in them. This is justice. What the hell are they mad about? You're getting justice. So why are they so angry? Maybe because they wanted to reconcile with you. And you're not interested. It's like they want to pick a fight with you here. They feel foolish for walking away. Want Yeah. You cut them off. They could have juggled you. It's because you ended things with them. It's because you ended things with them. Like, I don't know. This person's like a little obsessed here, to be real with you. It's like, I don't know if it's a dangerous obsession, but I think that they, for some of these people, they it has the potential to turn that way. Like this person feels jilted, and it's like, I don't think you're interested, Capricorn. Like, the majority of you are no longer interested in this person. But I think they still have feelings for you. You may have feelings for this person, but I don't think you're interested. Like, maybe you don't do do-overs, or maybe you don't go back to the past, or maybe you don't, you're moving on and you're moving forward, and they're angry. I think that this is, a person who's used to having their way, and I think that they're used to having control, and I think that they're used to having people chase after them, and you're not chasing them, and in fact, you may absolutely be telling the truth when you're saying, I'm not interested. You got them blown away here or shocked. I don't think they take very kindly to being told no. I don't think they like being told no. Yeah, well, I can't make it up. You're not interested. They can't get these facts on you. It's like they might be making up lies about you. I'm nosy, all up in your business. Trying to get the inside scoop here. And maybe they're broke. I don't know. I don't think they're getting along with their, if there was a third party situation here, I don't think they're getting along with that person. They're bitter. they are definitely looking you up. But you're played out with this person. You may have blocked them. Some of you are saying they ain't shit. You're like, I think that they're used to being chased, to be real. Let go one of their side pieces, go chase them. But the one who bothers them is you, because you don't chase, and you're legitimately, most of you, not interested. And they're like, what? What do you mean you're not interested? You're not interested. Just trying to start drama for you and making up lies about you because they're triggered. Because you're not interested. That's exactly what it is. You ain't interested. Period. And this has triggered them. What do you mean you're not interested? Nobody says no to me. Do you know who I am? You're like, I don't care who you are. I know who you are and I ain't interested. And they're mad. They're like, moi? Gee, you know, like they're supposed to be really more important than you or something? Played out. Done. Maybe you're living your best single life. It's, I don't know. It's like you're very confident. You are probably loving on yourself right now. And loving your life. Or trying to love your life. Or trying to whatever you're trying to do here. But they're pissed off with you because you're doing it. Like, who the hell are you to be enjoying your life? Who are you? They might want to start chasing you. Because they're not used to people turning them down. They're not used to people telling them no. This is someone who's been very spoilt and used to having things their own way. You got them shook. You got them shocked. You're not interested. They're having nightmares about it. You're the empress, and you're loving on your life, you're loving on yourself, you are doing you, and they can't handle it. I want to ask that question, is this person dangerous? Is this person dangerous? No, they're just a liar. And a player. Are they dangerous though? Is this a dangerous obsession? Is this a dangerous? Well, there's two sides to them. They're hot and they're cold. Uh, I don't know. They're stubborn. You got them shook. I don't know. You might have some feelings of fear around this person. I think that they might try to make you they're jealous. They are jealous. They're jealous of you talking to other people. They hate you getting attention. This pisses them off. That is somebody who has, like, we all have the potential to be mean. We all have the tendency to do this. I don't know who this King of Wands is, but they're a hothead. They have a jealousy. They hate that you're getting attention. They hate that you're getting attention, that you have friends, maybe, and you get a lot of attention. They hate it. I think they're drinking heavily, and I think they stew on things. I think that they start overthinking and overanalyzing things. So yeah, anybody in that situation has the potential to overreact. And this is overreacting. This is a vicious jealousy. This is a... They could... Especially when they drink, they cannot be trusted. Like, the potential is there. The potential is there. This could be the type that loses their temper and then says they're sorry. They lose it, and then they say they're sorry. But they're not. I don't like how they're trying to belittle you. I think they're trying to make you feel insecure about yourself and make you afraid to not make them angry. Like, maybe I better not talk to my friends, or maybe I better not do this because they will get angry. I don't like it. Like, I'm not getting, like, a fear in me, but some of you have experienced that, and it's real. Like, I don't know if they'd be crazy enough to come at you now, but the grudge is still there. And they do... this person that I'm reading for, so if it's not you, don't take offense. The person that I am picking up on in this read is someone who has the perplexity to be violent. It's a violent jealousy. And it could lead to an obsession. So you're going to have to be careful with that. Like, no means no. Like, this is a person you couldn't just remain friends with, because they'll ruin all your relationships. They don't like you getting attention from anyone. And you don't trust them. You don't trust them. You've lost trust in this person. People do weird stuff when they get that jealous rage in them. It's a jealous rage. And I don't find it cute. Some people say, you know, when you're in a relationship and they go, oh, they're so jealous, that must mean that they care. Maybe to a degree, but not like this. This is a jealous rage. And they may, you know, they may do it subtly. They may do it without you knowing. They might do it right to your face. I don't know. But this is somebody you cannot trust. They're volatile. And they are reactive. Take care.